The operational report. Looks like Whippoorwill has been hit, attacked a few times. Maybe that's my hint to leave. Useless. No, no, no. Okay, here. Oh, here's something at the end that is useful. Expansion. Okay. Naga is captured. They marched right up and captured it. Here are the Bolo planes. See, we returned 12 to the pool. One of them's back, or one's back, and I think there are 12 still coming. So we'll take out the rest of those Mitchell bombers. Reinforcements arrive. Almost want to play this game. I'm tempted to load this game onto two computers so that I can read this and also check out the sites at the same time, because every time you check one out, you move over and you come back. Oh, you got to go down to the, you got to scroll down to the bottom again. Just a suggestion for those who have two computers. We're over to China. This is our favorite little combat spot. I mentioned that we should keep an eye on. This is Kwe Sui up in the north. The enemy attacked on a deliberate attack, not a bombardment, a deliberate attack. They ran into 1 to 11 odds. So they're obviously pretty weak. They suffered a number of disablements. We also suffered a few disablements, but he's willing to fight it. Now, I want to bring your attention to this one, because we'll take a look at this. This is the combat zone. Oh, I'll just go onto the side here. You know, like that. We can see that, remember, last turn, this was at 119. We had actually increased one. By losing a couple of squads, we are now down to 116. We could probably think it's most likely this one, because it's the furthest, most damaged. We'll show the soft and say, hey, this is the one that has experience. So I can't be for certain, but I think this one bore the brunt of it. Now, the question is, what should we do? Notice this is 36, 36. I've actually gained two points, perhaps, of experience by getting damaged, by getting attacked. If we go and if I decide to recombine all these, rebuild all of them, that takes an average. I believe it will lose those two extra points. So do we keep them on, to keep them separate, and maybe when the next time he attacks a different one and we can go get higher? Who knows? Who knows? The important thing is, for me, I've noticed, is the experience has gone up. The assault value has dropped. We didn't know, no squads were destroyed, but they were disabled. So by being disabled, it just adds something else we have to recover. The enemy attacked deliberately, with a bombardment style. Now, one thing I should mention, notice these fortifications. These are forts. I don't know what the 1P, what 4P, I don't know if that means four pending or what. But these are, when a unit is stopped in hexes, in a base like this, you can build fortifications around the base. But even a unit in the field that stopped for any length of time automatically starts digging in fortifications. So if you stay long enough, let's say out here, you could check and see that some of these have built four. This unit's been here since the beginning. So they are, you can build fortifications as you're moving, but this unit is moving. These units in Changsha, see, they're built up to four. So these units are quite dug in. I don't know what the P might mean pending. Anyway, all we need to know is the higher the number, the better. I don't think if I reconstitute, I don't think it'll take away the fortifications, but the enemy was willing to attack last time. So I think I'm going to sacrifice this little it's experience. So it went up, but if I reconstitute in case of a new attack, it's now 36. If we divide Back to everyone's at 36. So I think I'm going to rebuild the unit in case the enemy attacks. If he doesn't, if he wants to bombard a few more times, we'll see what happens before we decide next turn whether or not to disperse. Taking a look, well, it's been a week now, so we'll take a look at our other units. Some of them have moved. This unit has not recovered any. We should turn everyone on for reinforcements, not just the first component. Out here, over in, here's the other Cheng Chao. We didn't have any combat last turn. We're still building. We're going to get to that next level, I hope. And we have 800 assault value in here. Oh, what happened to this one? Oh, yes, he got separated. So he's slow moving in. We'll go to combat mode. We'll turn on reinforcements for both of these units. Where is his compadre? Nope, it's not this one. Ah, here they are. This one's still moving south, almost there. Moving south, almost there. Ah, this one's moving slowly. Okay, he must have been bombed or something slowed him up. This one's also moving slowly. Okay, and this one's moving slowly. This one's at 42. The question is whether or not we'll be able to move down one hex next turn. I'm going to go to combat mode. I don't want to be caught in this hex. If the enemy attacks, I would not want. We've shown on the far side here, there's a negative modifier if you're hit while you're in the wrong mode. Okay, the rest are okay. Our units are just heading in from the moving across. We're fine here. Another unit we should be checking is in the woods here. They've arrived, so now we're going to move everyone to rest. Checking the soft, some of them have dug in all for a long time. The headquarters has been here a long time. I never thought I'd make it. Here's some more that have managed to... We were evading to the woods so that we could... this one will rebuild and divide again just to even out. Over here we have a unit that's moving. This one's arrived in the woods safely. We'll go to rest. And these are still moving. We're still running from here. This last time we got blasted. Assault strength is still 16. Do we turn on, take reinforcements? Yeah, he's so low. I'll toggle the reinforcements on. In Chuxian, we have a number of units. They're heading south. This is a very large unit. Not very large. This is 1, 2, 3, about 340. And we have the current value is about 1,300. So if we leave 1,000 here, we have 1,300 here plus the 400 here has about 1,700. If I divide them evenly, about 800 each, we'll want about 400 down there. I'm going to let the 70th Chinese continue to march. He's already almost out of the hex anyway. 70th Chinese. I think I'm going to keep the other Chinese unit in this hex. So we keep it up at about 800. Yeah, we'll keep it up at about 800 because here comes an enemy approaching. I don't want to be caught short. So this one, we're going to rebuild, lose all that movement. Rest. Oops. combat so that we can get the engineers to participate. We're set for Wenchao, but that's all right. We'll defend where we are in case we need to fall back to Wenchao. Here's a unit that's been moving. Oh, okay. He's got Wenchao. He's got Hangchao. Wenchao already has a headquarters. Do we need another headquarters? The support level is a little bit low, but we've got another unit coming across, so I think I'm going to... This one looks like it's going to have combat real soon. Oh, well, he's almost marched out of here. We'll let him march all the way down to Wenchao. The more... See, engineers and units work better when they are in sufficient support. So I'll gamble. I'll send the headquarters down south. Here's some more resting. Got to check through all these right now. Oh, we have one here moving. Okay. Recovering. Kukong. Do we have some units arrive here? Rebuild, combat, divide. Oh, another one. Rebuild, combat, divide. We're not taking replacements out here. We've got 600 plus we're building. Oh, the other reason I think the AI is bombing is he's trying to keep us disrupted and or prevent us from building up fortifications. But the amount, the bombing hasn't been very, very effective. I could show you one of these, like these here, the ones that he's hit, it's almost, there's no disruption, so they aren't very accurate. But every little bit help, every little bit could help if they actually hit something. Here is, that. These were, I think one of these was hit. Okay, so we're moving. This unit, there's that P for, I guess it's a in process, probably, because I think this unit just arrived. Our supply level isn't great, but we're almost at the 2. And this unit, last turn it was 45, so it moved 1 to cover 46 in here. So it moves at about 15 per turn across the open field, just for those who would like to plan or try to plan ahead. Okay. We're going to take a moment to check through. Oh, well, are there? No, there are no more replacements, so this is kind of a pointless exercise. The last bomber at Hami has moved off to join its parent unit, so we're going to move this one south. Oh, where to? Let's aim all the way for Chenchao. There's no garrison requirement here. It's always important to check these things. Yeah, I gotta remember to check every single one of these every single time. In the south, we are here in Wuchao. We've evacuated back to our unit. We'll rebuild. Oops, rebuild. Go into combat. Divide. We should also turn on, we'll turn on the replacements because we were in the field, we ran back, we've now got 400 here, about to build, I think we'll get a level 2 before the enemy arrives. Kukong is okay. Right. All right, now in Burma, another supply ship has left, that's great. We have one that's halfway done. We're here. This is what I have missed, and this was what I wanted to do at the beginning of the game. I started, and then I made a mistake. Okay, we're looking at the aircraft here, and we see the red number. This usually, red is always a bad thing. Like this, this says we're allowed to have 50 aircraft because this is a level 2 airfield. We're allowed to have 25 aircraft supposedly per level. So we
Ooh.
Or no, we're allowed to have 50 per level. So it's a level one airfield, and we have 54. So we're slightly over, but you're either over, you're under. I don't think they make, I'm not sure if they use percentage overages. So you're over or you're under. Nonetheless, we explained earlier why we can't fly away from this one because of the restricted part. That means we're short pilots here. And I forgot to do this. If I grab a replacement, let's see. Look at most of these pilots have experience of 50 or better. So they've got some, they're pretty decent pilots. We'll see. We'll check the Moolman one. He's taken replacements before, and we'll see that the pilots, see, these are the replacements. You get this stuff coming in at 25, 30, whatnot. This is cannon fodder. Well, not quite. It can get worse. But they're not as experienced as these guys up here. Boeington 80s, right? So they'll get killed quite easily. So you don't want to, if you hit the replacement, if you hit the replacement button, take a replacement, you're going to get one of those, but you'll probably get it right away or very, 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 very quickly. I think pretty much right away. However, if you go to a request veteran button, you can select from other, these are other air groups from your nationality. This would be a United, see, U.S. Army. You can select from U.S. Army pilots, even though we're under Chinese command. This is a U.S. Army squadron. So here are some of the pilots that are available right now from the other groups or in the general reserve, like fighter reserve, bomber reserve. We can sort those, and that's fine. We could grab one of these guys. I don't know where they are. So I well, there's kind of like a general pool of reserves, but we don't want to grab the bomber reserve. So I don't normally let the AI select for me. If we select it takes this long. It says about 6 days for this guy to come, this one day for these guys, one day or not. So I'm going to show what I was hoping to do at the beginning of the game. I have gone over to the West Coast, and we're going to just jump in here for a moment. Remember that Seattle we were using as a fighter training base here. This is just the example I want to let everyone see how it's done. We'll select this Cobra, the fifth, got, you may want to write this down or memorize it. 54th Pursuit Group, right? The little asterisk means that it's going to be withdrawn sometime. This one's going in January. Oh! That's terrible. Oh, gosh. Yep, these are all going to be with, well, this one's not. Let me find an example. I think there's one back here. No. Okay, well, don't have one of those examples. Nonetheless, we have the Seattle group, the Air Cobra. We've just grabbed some pilots for it. We just filled in. These are one, we only had two before, and we had, so these are what, 30 level experience, and the other two pilots that were already in the squadron are 57 and 60, but this is pretty decent, and we would want these guys in a combat situation now, wouldn't we? So to grab directly from this 54th Pursuit Group, this headquarters squadron, we're going to click on it. No, we're not transferring. We're going to right click on it. Reserve. How do you do that again? Okay, the top two. Okay, it's group reserve. We'll put this one, group reserve two. You see the delay is one here. All right, so the names are Ingram and Williamson, 54th Pursuit Group. This is just a sample. They're the two most experienced, and I'm going to want them. I can come back here to the squadron. Okay, we need it. I'm going to request a veteran. We want to, we can sort here. 54th Pursuit Group, 54th Pursuit Group. Here's Ingram and Williamson. Due in one. So we want to take this guy. Transfer. Yes. this guy, Williamson, transfer? Yes. So it takes 3 and 6 days to get him over, but we'll be getting veterans. So now he's been assigned to to the American Volunteer Group. We can go back to the previous squadron. Here's the headquarters squadron. See? And they want... So now we have room. We have pilots here. We have 4 pilots. We can take 2 more. See, this is a training squadron, because these are all rookie pilots. We'll get a replacement pilot, replacement pilot. The replacement pilots, notice how they appear instantaneously. No delay, they're here, but they're of this low quality. So this is how we can grab more experienced pilots directly into the forward squadron. It takes time, so that's why it's important to be monitoring them. And so here's the squadron. We have 20. It says 26, but when you show pilot, there's 28. And where's Ingram? The delay. Here we can sort by delay. Here's Ingram's and Williamson arriving in 3 to 6 days. This every squadron can hold pilots up to 1/3 over the number of aircraft. So this 1/3 of this squadron can hold up to 36 pilots. This is the way I should have done it right at the beginning, so that we didn't have these training squadrons back here don't need all those experienced pilots. We just need to get them into the front line. So I've suffered for it. We paid the price for it, and I can just, for simplicity's sake, I can just grab some replacement pilots. We didn't, when you get from the group reserve, see, this is the group reserve, all groups, there's also, the current group, right? We can also just, this is just the general reserve. We can grab fighter pilots from here. Notice the higher quality. Let's just fill it out. 1. These guys are in the hottest combat. Let's leave a few. Let's not do this. We'll get the rest. So we have this many pilots. We have 32 pilots now. I don't know how he's going to get 9 more. Oh! See, here's 6, 5. Sorry, here's the delay. Here where the pilots are going to arrive. So we'll just fill up the rest with replacements. 36 pilots. All those on, the rest are just replacement pilots. Look at that, low caliber pilots. Not the smartest thing to do, but we'll do the same thing on the request side. We will reserve. We were only going to take the fighter pilots, not the bomber pilots, because there's a penalty, I believe. I think it was something like 20 experience points, but I'm not that, I could be wrong. So we filled up a few more. We've got 31 pilots here, and let's just fill up the rest from the general replacement pool. So those cannon fodder. The positions seem to be doing well in the north. The base forces have where the heck is that? Lido. Okay, but we need to get them in combat. All 4 are here, unpacking. Looking at 4 engineers and a vehicle. We already have them, so we don't need further replacements. We just need for them to recover. Oh heck, everyone else is getting replacements, why not us? Here's the second south. combat, and all his mates are in Jorhat. So once he finishes unpacking, he should be able to join up with them. The Punjab Battalion will go into recovery. Look at all that damaged units. Here's the other half of the rest of the base force. Dimapur, same. Go into combat. Turn on the replacements. And we'll go into rest mode. Alright, so we've got another... We'll form up another transport group here. I guess you could almost consider these guys blockade runners. Oh, what happened here? What an idiot. Okay, you moron. Why did he run? I'll never understand. I'm going to dock him right here. He still had 1,000 supplies on him. And he took off. Here's another unit also heading out. I don't know if there's going to be enough space for both of them docking at Akyab. But we certainly do need the additional supplies. Have to check through all the stacks again. One at a time. Here we go. Finally, we get to rebuild this unit. We're at 25. Well, we could leave, but I'm going to wait for this one to recover a little bit more, because if we leave and there's an accident and one of them becomes disabled, we're under the garrison requirement again. The Maharatan Battalion, the 16th Company. The battalion has arrived, so the base fort runs for the frontier. Which one? We've got one here, we've got one here. So we'll support Lido. We'll change the planning also to Lido. A ship's arrived. Oh, we cannot dock. So we've already refueled. Good. We'll disband into the dock. Engineers, yep, all the support. So here's how we support. We'll take the ones, the units that are damaged, we'll just put them into pierside repair. Oh, this one. Okay, hopefully it'll be done in one day. I'll form a transport group when you have limited dock space. I like to take the biggest one. Dock it. Start loading supplies. Turn off the cargo. Now that she's already in the dock space, we're going to transfer some ships into it. We'll add more cargo ships, starting from size. I'm going to avoid taking the ones that have any damage. This way they can try to repair themselves. We'll keep. Notice how the first one, it's grayed out, means that it won't fit in the dock. So I will now check the next, but the next ones, these are yellow, so they will fit in the dock there. And now no more ships will fit in the dock. Look at all the sizes are filled up. This will fill up 48,000 of supply. I think we're going to do backwards. I'm going to disband it. I'm going to start differently this time. I've got tankers here. We'll go tankers first. I could be wrong here. I think tankers require loading from the dock, whereas transports can try to load over the beach. It's not as efficient. I could be wrong on that. I could be wrong. My gut feeling is tankers need more facilities than these. See? Well, and now, after putting the tankers in the dock, I will put the transports. And notice how half of these are too big, and the rest of these are able to fit on the dock. Now, none. So when we're loading supplies, the tankers will load fuel, the supply ships will load supplies. There's only so many low operational points per base. So the rest of them will just have to sit and wait. But there's 118. Oh, there's plenty. Here's another light regiment. Okay. We don't need it at Aden. We'll just guess where this one's going to be fighting. I will say Lido. Best guess. The Socotra element is unloaded. Okay. We'll head back. Make sure that the refuel is turned off so we don't suck the fuel out of our base. Nothing here. We're now down. Oh, jeez, that's slow. Okay. Still haven't gotten there yet. Check the bases here. Oh, we've got Ceylon detachment has. Oh, it's moving right past us, so we don't want to stop it. We'll move to the south. We'll see that the enemy has moved into the hex with us in Alora Star, just in time. See, we're almost all of them. This one, SSV Brigade, is not. So I'll go select infantry. We are going to expect an attack. The armored cavalry, the field regiment, artillery, the mountain guns, the air attack. So we're ready to fight. Just in time. This unit, got to be careful what's happening here. I ordered Mysore to try to march. Oops, to support Alostar, right? Watch what happens when you're sloppy. We'll check the road network, and now you can't march from Georgetown to Alostar. So it was trying to march up the road here and then back down. I don't want to get caught in the middle of nowhere, so I'm going to order it just to stop. Oops. Combat. We'll rest here. We'll just fight for... This means that if they retreat, they're going to be retreating down the road. If they retreat down the road, we may have to abandon Georgetown or expect it to fall very soon. And we're building very, very quickly with only 8 engineers here. So there's not much with which to stop them. We've got the fighters here. Not much here. We have 2 Australian brigades that we're heading up to fight them at Alostar. No, there's no way we're going into, it's like riding a train into a war zone. That's just, no. So instead, they've just got on the train, just embarked, and they haven't moved any yet. So we're going to stop over at Taiping instead. Here's an anti-aircraft unit. Okay, Singapore. The submarine has recovered. We're going to rush her in. Okay, plenty of room in the shipyard. The Prince of Wales is now up to 20 knots. I think it's probably time to leave. So we're going to move her out to readiness. The enemy's starting to bomb further and further, so I think it is time to flee. We have a number of task groups here. Here's a bunch of small ones. First off, the destroyers of task group 109, we're going to form up. Surface combat, sort for 109. Oh, we're going to do the cruiser group escorts as well. We're going to do a replenish at sea. so that hopefully we suck it dry from the tankers. Let's see right here. Yes, we sucked it right out of the tankers. Well, before it goes into the base. Either way, we want to get it into the base. Looking at the situation, Palembang only has 5,000 supplies, so it only needs a few small tankers or freighters to get it out of here, but it needs lots of, it's got lots and lots of fuel, 100,000 worth of fuel. We filled up Singapore to 100,000. I think this is way too much. The it's probably going to fall to the enemy when the base collapses, but it gives us a fighting chance. So this is the last run. This transport group here only has one unit with 600. This one just arrived, so we're going to transfer the units with supply. There's two of them, a seaplane tender, a submarine tender, over to it, dock, unload. Let's see, these are, well, we're still pretty full up on fuel, so we don't need to switch out. Okay, this is a very small group. Yeah, I think that's about right. These are all tankers. We have some more tanking facilities here. So we're going to take the empty ones. The unit that's still unloading has about 2, 4, 5, 6. Like that's enough. We can start grabbing the supplies and load out. But it's the tankers only carrying 15, 20,000. No, there's lots of room for additional fuel. So we're going to, these lighters are going to grab what they can and head southward. What group is that? Number 109. We'll transfer into 109. Select, turn off the import. We have to turn it off every single time. We're docked, so we can't get any, we are out of space here. So we'll undock, transfer some more. 109, there go all the transports. These will be heading, yeah, Batavia, here we go. Transfer. Okay, we have, this is a pretty decent escort group, pretty decent sized. We're going to transfer over to the other group that's just sitting here waiting. We'll transfer out the empty oilers and empty tankers. Should be all right. These are long-range tank because there's not much in Batavia. 50,000 is not very much when it comes to tanker fuel, whereas 100,000 at Palembang, that makes it interesting. So this unit here, this group here, it's not very much. There's only 20,000 or so left. Once it unloads, it's heading for Palembang. It'll take the short-range escorts. The long-range, heading for Batavia. Okay, that should be a pretty decent group. Over on Kuching, we're going to form a amphibious group. There's only really one ship here. Oh, there's more than one ship here with units on it. All right. Okay, we'll form an amphibious group with the empty. Transports. We're going to load troops. Oh. Okay, we'll examine the Punjab rifle. We'll take them. Sarawak, it's going to withdraw in 382 days nonetheless. and the base force is not a withdrawal. So we Sarawak force is going to be the least desirable. Let's see, if we can't fit them, we won't take them. Load troops, the base force, the Punjabs, verify. See, it says we need 1,000 more. Is it really that we need 1,000 more, or just another one of those failed calculations? So I'm going to play it safe. We're abandoning the Sarawak force because they are withdrawing within a few days anyway. So now that we've got them started loading, we will add the other ships back in, because they won't be loading any, set for Sohar Baha. We'll check for ships with endurance. If there's anyone in so we have to form up, we'll form another amphibious group with the very low endurance vessels. Oh, we can't replenish from port. Dock. Okay, replenish from the port. That's okay. Getting some is better than getting none. So there we are, ready to run. We're loading troops as soon as they're loaded, hopefully before the cruisers get here. We had an air attack just last turn. We fought it off, good. And two search planes here. There are, okay, no any other ships waiting here. Nope. So this one, we're going to sail out and meet, which one is it? This is the one that's heading south. Transport. We're going to meet and merge. We're not going to unload. We're going to make sure this guy is set for do not unload. When we get down there, we're hitching a ride with the escorts. Hope we haven't seen any submarines this close to shore, so I think we're okay. We did see one up here, and we did see one over. There was an attack here, so I'm hoping we'll link up here. It's just a guess. We're checking submarines in the area. Here's a damaged one, heading 016. Let's see if we can get her back to Singapore. Here's another one damaged, but let's go for Singapore. How convenient it is to have your own little dry dock. Checking the ammo on all of them. See, this one, it's important. We start off, I think this is two torpedoes, so there's a total of 7 torpedoes here. We only have 3 left, but I think it's important to note that this is a rear-firing tube, so these are the offensive weapons, not so much these. I don't know how it fired, maybe at an escort, perhaps, that was chasing it. So I'm looking at these, it's still, when a sub still has 2 weapons, I think I'm going to let it go, because they often fire them in barrage in salvos of 2. If they still have 2, then they are, I think they'll still be able to engage. The battalion here is now satisfying the garrison requirement, so now this is where you die. Notice that the damage was to the runway. It could also have damaged some of the manpower, resources, or light industry, I think. That's what partisan attacks can do. We don't have any engineers here, so I don't think it's going to repair the airfield damage. Sohar Baha, all the ships combine into one task force, still loading up fuel. It's a decent size, but I think we can wait for a few more ships before the convoy heads south. We'll finish this one and probably send it off, because we don't want to overtax the facilities at, oh, here's another one coming in. Yeah, we could probably do both of these, but it will overtax the facilities. At Darwin's only got a little 3 here, so we'll have to send off in 2 groups. We'll finish loading here. The cruiser is Houston, and it's slightly damaged. Oh, we cannot put it in dry dock. Okay, but we'll give it a high priority rating in readiness mode. This should be able to get it done in 1 day. Let's see, Houston has some seagulls. Oh, gray, no. We want to, let's see, we can't upgrade because pool number is insufficient. Group upgrade is off, no group upgrade path. Well, the pool number is plenty. So, done. Still not. Oh, supply level is below. We need airfield 5, supply level 20,000, of which we don't have here. Okay, good. This is a nice little explanation they put in there. For years, people couldn't figure it out, and I couldn't figure it. It was always something, but at least they're telling us now that's a really nice change, recent. Okay, make sure all the tenders are loaded. Everyone's refueled. This time I won't make the mistake. If there's a tender here, I might have to leave it behind for the PT boats, but do I the PT boats are 2, 4, they're all what? They're maybe 10 or 15 points. Should I sacrifice a tender? Where's the tenders? Here's the tenders. The gunboat tenders like this, which are worth 4 or possibly more, just to support gunboats that are going to be retired after one shot. So another thing to consider. With the evacuation of Borneo, I think we cannot turn off the oil, but we can try to turn off the refinery. So we don't leave them they're already going to get some fuel. That's more than I'd like to give them, but I forgot to turn it off earlier. And another refinery here, we'll just turn that off too. Brunei, that's oil, but Miri has the refinery. We'll leave it. Oops, we'll turn the production off, but it's damaged already. So hopefully the enemy will put supply points in there to be wasted. At Manila, the whippoorwill, she's pushing her luck, I think. She's been bombed twice already. I don't think anyone would fault her for leaving. We'll dock, replenish. Okay, we tried to... Oh, I guess she'd fired off some ammunition from her deck gun. Should I risk running into Manila? No. We're going to... Gosh. Use a waypoint. We're coming to the southern route. There's a submarine here, S-37. Finished her patrol, refueled. Mac reaction. We'll send it right into the landing zones. Oops, that's not a landing zone. That's a landing zone. To we don't want to. I'll just send it off here. The aircraft from Iba. We are finally able to transfer her with her mates in Manila. At Clark Airfield. They didn't arrive yet. So he's still moving forward. Naval search. We're very close. Required is 96. He's got no air cover here, so I'm going to we're going to fly it into Manila. Maybe we should have gone to Clark. Probably look at all that. Look at all that. Should have gone to Clark. Okay. We'll send this one to Clark. Relieve the strain on the airfield. Let's reattach the unit. We'll get some pilots for this one. I'm not going to take time to go finding it. We'll fly it over to Clark as well. So that should bring us under the level. Good. We had some night fighters flying, but it wasn't enough, and the enemy... Oh gosh, should I get some fighter... To heck with it. I'll just go the easy way. We'll fire a range of 2. Okay. Also want to show something with the aircraft. There's 5 available right now. So I'm going to call up, before I take those, I'm going to call up the A. We're going to show the United States fighters. We're sorting across the type. We'll take a look at the Warhawks. The Warhawks are being flown out of Manila almost exclusively, and a few training squadrons in the rear. So I'm going to... Oh, it's this one. This is in Manila. We'll take the 4 pilots. Rookies can die as well as a veteran. This is the Far East. This is also at Manila. Sure. Just means they get shot down more quickly. But we can't wait too long. Okay, so the Warhawks, the aircraft for reinforcements, we can draw 5 of them. Since all the Warhawks are already in the front line, all the Warhawk squadrons are in the front lines, right? Manila, 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 and these 2 don't count because they're training squadrons. What I'm going to do is draw replacements. Fill them up. Oh no, we want to draw it down to a level of 1 and no more. So there's 1 here now. With this 1, I'm going to go to the rear. We're going to find a fighter squadron, a regular one, not one that's going to be leaving, like this Era Cobra. We're going to upgrade this Air Cobra to the Warhawks. Upgrade, because this fighter squadron is not departing. Yeah, we'll keep the original track, so what? You keep it low. So now, we're Warhawks. We're set to use 1. We have given up 24 Air Cobra. Are there any other aircraft? I'm going to date this Air Cobra. Now we go to one of the squadrons in the... Let's take a fighter squadron. Any fighter squadron. One that's going to be leaving. No. Here's a fighter squadron that's going to be departing in January. We have to give it full okay, why can't we upgrade? No possible reason. Well, Let's see. Let's go to the one in the rear. Let's see if that will be a possible reason. Let's find what... We really want these Lightnings. These Lightnings are good aircraft. Will they allow us to... Nope, it won't allow us to upgrade to the Air Cobras either. Trying to stick the aircraft to... Cannot it off? Let's see. Let me find a way. Got it. Found it in the eastern. We go to... We have, what, how many? We have 24 Air Cobras in the pool. So we go to the Lightning here. These are pretty decent aircraft compared to most of the others. So I'm going to choose the one with 5. We're going to upgrade to the Air Cobra. We're going, or downgrade. Doesn't matter. He'll be leaving in May. So we'll downgrade it, set it down to 0. So now we've got 5 Lightnings back in the pool, which we can keep and send the Air Cobras to Europe. We're also going to switch them out for the Warhawks. Let's see, here's another Air Cobra. We want to keep the P-40Es because they're actually good fighters. So we'll switch out with upgrade now. Yeah, it doesn't matter. He'll be leaving in July. We'll turn it off. So now we'll have some more P-30Es. Let's see, how many have we got left? We have 14 more, so let's switch out a couple more. Here's another. It's a Warhawk. This is a headquarters company, so they're very small. Let's switch out with Air Cobra. Done. So if we have to send aircraft, we'll send the Air Cobras. We'll keep the Warhawks. The Air Cobra. There's still 9. Let's look for another headquarters company that we can take out. None here. Any in Pearl Harbor. None of these are headquarters companies. But are any of them leaving? No, it doesn't. The P-40s aren't that much difference. Okay, here. No, let's see. Are there in the east? So we'll collect all these Air Cobras. We currently have 9 Air Cobras, and that's not enough to switch out for some of these Lightning squadrons. So I'm going to, which one? We'll find a regular squadron Air Cobra. Any up front? Oh, these are not regular squadrons. Okay, no more switches. Looks like we used them all up, but at least we'll have a few P-38 in the pool, sacrificing a few of the lesser P-39s. At Manila, we have these reconnaissance aircraft, the Philippine Army, but there are no more pilots. I guess they've all been killed, and there probably aren't going to be any more coming, so we're just going to... should we withdraw or disband? Let's withdraw. Over Port Moresby, we start marching, and we've moved 3 in one day. So at this rate, it'll take 16 days to get into this hex for pickup. The Catalinas are finished. We'll start picking up the detachment, Horn Island detachment. Let's see, how many are there left? Yeah, plenty. Here comes the Penguin. Oops, let's send him for wrong base. Send him for Townsville. The convoy is almost empty, so we'll be heading back to Townsville quick soon. This one's ready, loaded. Oh man. Do we send a one ship convoy? Yes, we're going to take that risk. For 3,900 supply points, we'll take that risk. Okay, now we can combine all these. We could, but as I stated earlier, we want to maintain flexibility. Here is the base force. We rebuild. Now we can do the replacements and upgrade. Over at Townsville, we will... These all have engineers, so everyone's going to drop into combat. Except for the armored regiments. They have no need. They have no engineers to contribute, so we may as well leave them all packed up, ready for transshipment. This is the base force we're sending over to Tulagi. We'll form it up now. We have to buy it out with political points. We'll select the 1st Australian Corps. I think it's only cost 1/4. Rather than 60 points, it'll cost 15 points. So watch this. Yep, it cost us 15 points only. Now we'll form the ship. This might be extravagant, but we bought out the engineer unit. We're also going to send... Let's see. If we send infantry... This is the biggest unit we have here that's independent, but it will be withdrawn in 500 days. So that's another year. Spend now or spend later. If we buy it, we do have some extra points. I am going to buy it. It's done. We'll set it for Tulagi. Now we're going to load. I will form up. The first and foremost is going to be okay, we're going to load this force. Is it enough? We will load everything, verify. Whoa, looks like 198%. Wow, seems like plenty. Let's go use minimum. Should I be using such a big ship? Let's take a look. This says 2,000. So if it's 150% extra, okay, let's load the cavalry. Let's use minimum. Use all. Let's verify it. It says it needs more. Let's add more. 7% load safety factor for troop. So we want to add another ship. 56%. I think that's safer, simply because we want to make sure we load everything first time. So we'll accept that load. We'll form a second group. Transport. Armored. Let's go Katoomba. Load troops. The Royal Navy. Let's verify. 100. Well, plenty of room. Okay. Let's do it that way. So once they load, we'll head off next turn. In the north, I'm going to buy out this Royal Navy force. Do the same. We still have lots of points. Or not lots, but enough. I think the problem with getting unloading in Port Moresby is they don't have enough support, because it's only 26 naval support and it's a small base. So if we can get some naval support in there, we're loading it up. Here comes the supply convoy. We'll load up here. It's going to take one day to pack, and we can set it up next turn. We'll keep a couple of political points open in case we need them for something else. So here's another group coming in. Transports, that's fine. They're empty. We already have a group of transports here with 29,000. That's even too much for Tulagi, because it's a limit of 8,000 on there. We can put more on there, but there's a spoilage factor, so it may not be worthwhile. There's no other engineer units here. This is a static unit, so we can't send anything out to help them. Cavalry Brigade does not have engineers. The rest of the Australian Brigade. Oh, we could send 260. That's 60 points. Okay. We'll send 1st Australia Corps. At first point, I was joking about, oh, well, we're not going to risk too much. But now the more I make of it, the more I'm risking, aren't I? So perhaps I have gotten ahead of myself. I was risking one little base force. Now I'm risking a whole brigade. Let's see. Okay, let's verify, get more ships, 186%, let's add a ship. Use minimum, let's remove these. Back, turn it off, turn it on. Verify. So there's only 8% cargo surplus. So we're going to, let's transfer in some transports. That's not already used. 3 transports. Let's try it again. 300%? Yeah, let's do that. So we'll send some armor, or a couple of brigades to support. That's lots. Okay, ship's going off. Let's see, have we finished the Rarotonga load? Yes, we got them all. And this one is still burning. Uh-oh. Yeah, she's a goner. This one seems to have her damage control. Oh, this one's still stuck. How much more? We're looking for the 6-inch guns. Are they able to pick them up? We have 90%. Are there any 6-inch? There may not be any 6-inch guns on here. It could just be that they cannot get them off. So for that reason, we're going to stop the loading and go. The Dutch start the attack with 4 torpedoes. Sailfish attacks off Taiwan. but it's the Japanese who score first, sinking a light freighter. Perch returns the favor. Night attack on Clark Field. The AI has found a hole in the defenses. Nanning is bombed. S-40 strikes. The Dutch sub attacks but takes damage in return. Skipjack fires and misses. The Japanese do not. Another failed attack. S-41 misses. Another failed attack. The Dutch fire and miss. Not this time. Rabaul is bombed. Air attack, Wen Chao. Air attack, Alor Star. Afternoon air attack, Alor Star. Whoa, we get the Buffaloes fight hard. Clark Field bombed. Kansien bombed. Alor Star hit again. Kukong bombed. Kuilin bombed. Clark Airfield bombed again. Tamara sinks, so does the Dutch sub. Ground attack, Alor Star. 1-2. Serious casualties on our side. The enemy unit is sending a tank regiment. Bombardment at Kwe Sui. Bombardment at Nanning.